On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. And I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a rugged cross.
Good evening and greetings in the mighty name of Jesus. You are welcome to your usual program, Help from Above.
It's
prepared by the Nupe intercessors and presented to you by Brother Vin Baba.
Let's
bow our hearts to prayer. Father, we thank you again for this time. Thank you for preserving us. Thank you for drawing our hearts to come to hear your word. As we have come, we ask that you will speak to us. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Now, our theme had been the power of the cross. And our text have been from 1 Corinthians chapter 1 verse
18.
The message of the cross is the power of God. And we have been looking at this cross of Christ, the cross on which Christ died, that to many it was foolishness. But it is the wisdom of God to solve the problem of humanity on earth. It is the power of God by which he sought to deliver man from all that man entered into on account of his fall from the beginning. For the Lord had foreseen the all-knowing God. He has seen the fall of man long before man fell, and he had designed how he was going to deliver man from all that man we enter into on account of that fall. And by the way, God kept coming to solve the problem of man on earth. He kept doing things that points to the cross long before Christ died on the cross. God kept solving the problems of a man in a way that points to the cross. See how he came to clothe man when man became naked. And he shed the blood of an animal and of the skin, he used it to clothe man. See how he saved Noah from the flood that came.
Ile kendo na soko ganu agwa kamina zizen nwabe e defushu ina ye.
See the provisions he made for Abraham in the day that he was about to kill Isaac.
Chin ena soko jin cha gogwa nya efona Ibrahim gazun egiu isaku na le.
All of them pointing at the cross.
All
of them a shadow of the cross. Now today we want to look at the story.
It's
a long story which we cannot be able to read all the text. But you will see it in Exodus chapter 2. Up to chapter 10 is the story of how the children of Israel were delivered from the land of bondage, Egypt. But first of all, remember how they entered into Egypt. There was famine in the land. And there was bread in the land of Egypt. So they went there to look for bread. They went there to look for that which will sustain them. And that was how they entered into bondage. If you also look at the way man fell, the Bible said, if saw that the fruit was good for food, pleasant to the eyes, as if it will improve the life of man, and she went for it. The man ate with her, and they entered into bondage. Let me say this very quickly, that we need to be careful when we are searching for bread, searching for a better livelihood, to make sure that Satan does not rope us into bondage while trying to do those things. Let's make sure, as we search for jobs, schools, that there's no rope attached to all of these that will drag us into bondage. Of course, generally speaking, because of what Adam did, all of us, we have entered into the bondage of sin and into the bondage of the devil. The things that we like to do, we find them difficult to do. It is the things that we don't like to do, those are the things that we see ourselves doing. And so the children of Israel, they entered into bondage in the land of Egypt under a king, the king of that land called Pharaoh. And they were there. They were there as slaves. They were there for a long time. Almost 430 years. And maybe they were thinking that one day will come that the king will allow them to go free. Maybe they were thinking that one day will come the king will move with mercy in his heart towards them. But that never happened. Also with us, if we are thinking that a day will come that Satan is going to set us free from his prison. His prison of sin. His prison of sinful habits. Drunkenness, lying, wickedness. If we are thinking that day will come, that day will never come. For the children of Israel, that day never came. The Bible said in Isaiah chapter 14,
Verse 17,
describing the devil, that he did not open the house of his prisoners. He does not open the door so that they will come out. He will not. Maybe you are thinking, one day I will stop drinking. One day I will stop this and that. By yourself. That day will not come. That day will not come. He doesn't open his prison doors. Even when a man struggles with himself, of course, by our own power, we cannot open that door. The children of Israel, they cried and cried and cried. Pharaoh will not let them go. Women cried. His heart did not break. Children cried. His heart did not become merciful. And when Moses came and spoke for the people, he said, "Let my people go. They want to worship the Lord in the wilderness. They want to serve the Lord their God. Let them go." Pharaoh will not let them go. He will not let them go. Look, it's true that we all want to serve the Lord. We all want to live a good life. We all want to have a good home. We all want to live a life that is pleasant to God. We all want to worship God. But he will not let us go. Pharaoh will not let us go. He will not break his yoke of sin and let us go to serve the Lord. And so Moses came. He began to perform great miracles upon the land so that Pharaoh will see it and let the people go. Yet he did not let them go. In fact, he told his tax master, he said, "It's like you have not suffered these people enough. That is why they are even thinking that they want to go and serve the Lord. Trouble them the more. Deal with them the more. Put more hardship on them." And so it is also when Satan begins to see that a life is beginning to desire freedom from his power, he will begin to multiply troubles for that life. When he begins to see that the person is desiring a good life, righteous life, he will begin to multiply sorrows for that life. Once he see that this
person is beginning to want to serve God sincerely, he begins to cause more trouble for that life. So their troubles multiplied. They suffered them the more. And they kept crying. But Pharaoh never heard. Now Moses came and began to perform great wonders in the land. But the king never did let them go. He never let them go. Their water was turned to become blood. And for many days, they had nothing to drink. Yet Pharaoh will not let them go. God commanded under the hands of Moses frogs upon the land. They were finding it difficult to eat. Frog will jump inside their food. Yet Pharaoh did not let them go. He will not open the door for his prisoners to be free. Flies came upon the land. He will not let them go. Their livestock died. He will not let them go. Boils came on them everywhere. Every one of them. Boils came on their faces, came on their hands, came everywhere. They were in pain. But no, they did not open the prison doors. God sent hail and destroyed all the crops that they had. Locusts came on them. But he did not let them go. Look, no matter how we struggle, Satan will not let man go. What he has put on man, sin, wickedness, he will not let us go. He will not let us go. But hear what God said in Exodus chapter 11, verse 1. And the Lord said to Moses, I will bring one more plague on Pharaoh and on Egypt.
So,
afterward, he will let you go. Afterward, he cannot keep you longer. He will let you go. Afterward, he will even be the one driving you out. He cannot be able to keep you again. Friends, God has made a promise that the captive of the mighty will be delivered. The prey of the terrible will be delivered. That is Isaiah chapter 49, verse
25.
God fulfilled that promise to them. And he has fulfilled that promise also to us. And he wants to fulfill that promise to you. After that, the word of the Lord says, Pharaoh will let you go. He will let you go. And what was that plague? That plague pointed to the cross. He told them to get a lamb, to kill that lamb, and put the blood of that lamb upon the top of their doors and by the sides, and be ready. As you are doing it, be ready. Wear your shoe. Put on your belt. Take your staff. Be ready. Be ready. Because once that is done, your bondage will break. Your bondage will break. Pharaoh, we have no choice but to let you go. But to let you go. And that points to the cross. That points to Christ dead on the cross. And we thank God that had already happened. That plague had already come to pass, waiting for you to believe. To believe. And accept that which Christ did on the cross is the final thing, that is to break the bondage that you have found yourself in. The bondage to sin, the bondage to the powers of darkness that have troubled your life so much. There are some people that cannot sleep in the night. Terrible dreams. Things will be pursuing them here and there. Oh, it is for you that Christ died. It is for you that Christ went to the cross. Are you under some terrible habits that you have struggled with? If you believe on the cross of Calvary, if you believe, you will be set free. If you come to Jesus, the power of Pharaoh will break over your life. You will be set free. Are you in a secret cult and you are trying, you are desiring to come out? The power of the cross will break that door and release you. You will go free. The power of the cross will open every prison door that you are in. Are you under a curse that have not allowed you to make progress this many years? The power of the cross will break that door, and you'll be free to make progress even in your lifetime. As soon as that was done, Pharaoh pleaded with them and told them to go now, and they were released unto freedom. The struggle of many years ended. The tears of many years ceased that day. From being slaves, they became free men and women. Free to serve the Lord sincerely. Free to live a life of righteousness. Free to live a life that pleases God. Now, I'd like us to pray together. I don't know the situation that you are in. I don't know that which you have struggled with over the years. I don't know the imprisonment that you have found yourself in these many years.
Come
and believe on the cross of Christ. Where you are, can we pray together? Can you bow your heart where you are? And say, Jesus, oh, I believe today. I believe today that you died on the cross for me, and that the power from your cross can set me free, can set me free from Satan and from sin. Jesus, wash me by your blood. Come into my heart. Come and break the power of sin. Open the door of this prison for me. And let me go to serve you. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, thank you for this that you have shared with us. We ask, oh God, that you will grant us understanding more and more, and bring us to a point where we are taking a definite decision to receive Jesus into our hearts. Thank you, in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Now, if you have given your life to Christ, we can help you further. Or you have troubles in your life, and you want us to pray with you. You are under certain chains spiritually, and you want us to pray with you. Or you have certain questions that you want to ask. You can call us on these numbers. Same time next week, Saturday 5 to 5:30 p.m. we will be bringing you the word of God. God bless you, and thanks for listening.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. And I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for that old rugged cross. I